we know the innovation cycle in Chinese AI has been very fast. But what happens if that slows down? I mean, sometimes people are, I'm hearing concerns, for instance, DeepSeek hasn't released a second reasoning model. I mean, is that something that you need to be worried about?
Let's see. I would say as just like a single organization or single person, you really cannot go that fast for a long time, okay? You know, you collapse, okay? Like, you know, I can work in like for 3 days and without any sleep, but not anymore, okay? Not anymore. And you really cannot like work 30 days and don't have any sleep, okay? No way you can do that, okay?
Work ethic in China is famous.
But I would say collectively, we can have a very fast iteration, okay? Like, so that's why I really like a startup mindset. So basically, you know, like DeepSeek could do something very fast, okay? And then we also have Queen, okay? And then we have Kimi, okay? So collectively, and we can push that fast. I think that's okay. Actually, that's what I think it's important. Otherwise, why we need that population, okay? So that's why, you know, when people get together, and it's not just for, you know, competition, whether you win or not. It's basically, you can have the very fast iteration of the technology because of this competition or because, you know, and you work fast this time and you slow a bit, and then other guy move very fast. Mm-hmm. And eventually we slow down a bit. And if you're good enough, you can catch up again. And I don't think it's brutal, but I think it's very healthy because, and when we work with the people that is very competitive, that would be make you very much more competitive, because that was the way how I think the new technology invented. Yeah,
you're talking, I guess, about more of a marathon, not just a sprint race.
Yes.
Is there space though for new contestants to enter that race today?
I would say at least for AI, it's a marathon, because I think nobody could really see, you know, if it's a long journey, it's definitely in the very beginning, okay?
I think something that we see right now is certainly money that's being directed at strong talent.
Yeah.
And there's stories, of course, in Silicon Valley, we see people that are getting hundreds of millions of dollars.
And
what do you think about that?
I think it's... I don't think it's the typical way of doing things. Okay, I would say that. The reason is very simple. You know, with my own example, when I started the Alibaba Cloud, you know, the first thing I did, that was in 2008. The first I did to visit the Silicon Valley, and to try to get talent. Okay, And after talking to all the people, and you realize actually, we don't have much talent there, because it's new.
Okay.
So, and also with some of the talent, it's just too expensive. Okay, and too expensive basically means okay, you don't know whether the cloud business is there. Mm-hmm. Why need to hire these people? So it's really about the innovation. So when you are in the early stage of innovation, I don't think talent is a problem, because you know, the only thing you need to do is to get the right person, not really the expensive person. Because if the new business, if it's true innovation, that basically means it's talent. Nobody care about them. Okay, otherwise you're going to work on that. So for the today, what happened for the like matter is because they are very much focused on the existing success of the business and existing establishment of technology. That's my view. Okay, so I think we have a tremendous opportunity to look at technology nobody knows today, and these are talent, but these are I can't say it's cheap, but it's available for you. Okay. So that's really about the vision, you know, where you want to go. And there's a lot of similar things, you know, happened during the last 20 years or so. Whenever everybody knows that these are talent and it's better for you not to get in. And at least that's not new. That's my son. Like personally, that I hide Zhejiang now. He's head. He's the leader for the Queen. Okay, you probably met him. You know, when you were in Hangzhou. You know, I personally interviewed him. You know, 15 years ago, and we got talent. Now, he's leading the Queen. Yeah, but so that's.
So
that's,
there's not really any justification that it sounds like you think for such salaries.
Yeah, so I think that's not what happened in Silicon Valley is not the winning formula. That's what I believe. You know, yeah.